Entity graphs and join fetch clauses provide an easy and efficient way to fetch an entity and initialize its associations. But if you try to use it with a domain model that uses inheritance, you will quickly run into an issue. You can't use this approach in a polymorphic query to fetch an association that's defined on a subclass. Or in other words, your join fetch clause or entity graph needs to reference an entity attribute that's defined by your superclass. Otherwise, Hibernate will throw an exception because the attribute is unknown for some subclasses. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen, and I'm solving Hibernate and JPA problems for a living. In this video, I will show you how to avoid this issue using your first-level cache and multiple queries. If you are new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence-related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if it makes your developer life easier. By doing so, you are helping me to reach more people with it. Okay, back to the topic. There is an easy workaround based on Hibernate's first-level cache and its guarantee that there is only one entity object for each database record in your Hibernate session. Let's take a look at an example and I'll show you how this workaround works. The topic of this video was inspired by a question on Stack Overflow for which I was able to claim the bounty with an answer I prepared on a Coffee with Torben livestream. If I'm not teaching a workshop for a customer, I'm hosting these streams every Wednesday. The model I'm using is simple. An author can write different kinds of publications, like books and blog posts. These two kinds of publications share the attributes ID, version, title, publishing date, and a reference to the author. Blog posts get published on their author's blog, so they have the additional attribute URL. Books might be published by a publisher, which I modeled as a reference to another entity in our small domain model. There's nothing special about the entity mappings. I used the inheritance type single table to map the publication, book, and blog post entities to the same database table. The book entity also defines a association to the publisher entity. The inheritance type single table enables us to define a polymorphic one-to-many association mapping between the author and the publication entity. Okay, let's answer our initial question. How can you initialize the association between the book and the publisher entity if you get an author with all their publications? If you expected to do this in one query, I have to disappoint you. Hibernate doesn't support that. But using the following workaround, you only need two queries. That is much better than the n plus one queries you would need without it. So, how does it work? As I said, Hibernate only supports join fetch clauses or entity graphs on attributes that are defined by all entity classes of a polymorphic association. Due to that, you need an extra query to get the books with their publishers. In the next step, you then need to reuse these objects when processing the results of the second query. Let's check this in the IDE. By using Hibernate's first-level cache and its guarantee that within a Hibernate session, a database record gets only mapped by one entity object, you can implement this very efficiently. Your first query gets all the book entities and their publisher, which you need for your use case. In this example, these are all books written by an author with the first name Torben. As you can see, the query isn't too complex. I join from the book to the author to be able to define the where clause, and I use a join fetch clause to initialize the association between the book and the publisher. When Hibernate processes the result of this query, it adds all entity objects to its first level cache. When it then needs to process the result of another query, which returns book entities, Hibernate first checks if that entity object is already stored in the first-level cache. If that's the case, it gets it from there. This is the key element of this workaround. It enables you in the second query to ignore the association between the book and the publisher entity. Because Hibernate will get all book entity objects from the first-level cache, the association to the publisher entity will be initialized anyways. Here you can see the query that gets all publications of the author with the first name Torben. Thanks to the inheritance mapping and the mapped one-to-many association, this query is very simple. Let's try this workaround using the following test case. It first executes the two described queries, and then writes a log message for each retrieved publication. If the publication is a book, this log message includes the name of the publisher. And I also included log messages that will show the object reference of the book entity objects. This will show you that Hibernate always returns the same object instance for the book entity. As you can see in the log file, Hibernate only executed the two expected queries. Even though the second query did not initialize the association between the book and the publisher, the lazily fetched association is available. As the logged object references show, Hibernate used the same book entity object in the result of both queries. As you can see, Hibernate's first-level cache and its guarantee that each session only uses one entity representation for each database record can be used to create very efficient implementations. And before you start to worry, this workaround is based on well-documented behaviors and key features of JPA and Hibernate. This is future-proof, and you don't need to worry about it when updating your Hibernate dependency. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content like a cheat sheet for this video and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!